Hey everyone, and welcome to Boston Auto Blog. It is so nice and refreshing to still feature small cars on this channel. Now, we live in an era of crossovers where everyone wants to buy, whether it's small or large, they want to buy a crossover because of the practicality. However, I am going to start this review off with a bold statement. And I'm going to say that this generation of the Audi A3 is the patriarch of its segment in its era. Now, I'm already reading the comments right now. Mike, how could you say that? Or Mike, you have no idea what you're talking about because small cars have been a part of the automotive industry for decades. And you're also going to say that, Mike, the Audi A3 you're sitting next to is around the same size as like the B5 A4. But I understand that. I'm hearing you completely right now. But with this generation of the Audi A3, it came out around 2015, 2016. And in that time, over the last 4 years, we have seen the CLA, we've seen the A-Class, and we have the new 2 Series Grand Coupe. So this segment has grown significantly over the last 4 years in an era and time when small cars makes absolutely no sense. Now, conventional wisdom says that small cars aren't necessary anymore. However, German brands beg to differ, and that's because these small cars right here draw in a lot of new consumers to the brand. So when the Audi A3 first arrived in the United States, they sold around 30,000 of these per year. So that's a lot of new Audi loyalists. But if you're around my age, around 27 to 28 years old, you are a young professional. You want to buy a luxury car. And the Audi A3 and cars like it are perfect because they're under $40,000, and most likely, you don't need that practicality. You're not married yet, you don't have a family, so a car of this size is perfect. But also more importantly is that this car right here introduces you to a German brand. And what I will say is that within about 3 to 5 years, depending on what your need is, depending if you need practicality, you're going to be showing up to buy a Q5 or an Audi S4 if you want performance. So in this review, we're going to go over the Audi A3 and see why it might be the perfect first luxury car for you. Now, before I get in this review, I'd like to thank Ira Audi of Peabody in Peabody, Massachusetts for allowing me to do this review. The link will be in the description below so you can check out their extensive Audi inventory. And so, without wasting any further time, let's get right in this review. In 2020, there's a vehicle for everyone, from sedans to crossovers and even station wagons. Despite consumers leaning towards SUVs, one segment in particular has always been important to German brands, and that's the luxury small car market. As we've seen recently, competitors are beginning to understand the importance of these vehicles, as not only are they targeting consumers with a budget right around $40,000, but they're also reaching first-time new car buyers for the brand. With Audi reintroducing the A3 to the United States back in 2015 after a very brief hiatus, this time going with a sedan rather than a hatchback, they unintentionally became trendsetters, as Mercedes-Benz and BMW have followed suit within the last year. What's made the A3 successful since 2015 is the pricing, but also the luxury car experience along with an upscale road presence that resembles its bigger siblings. For 2020, the base price starts just over $33,000, but with the model we have today being a premium plus, you're looking at a cost of around $43,000. When it comes to dimensions, the A3 is sized identically to most of its competitors, and is exactly 10 inches shorter than the A4. With younger consumers residing in urban areas, the A3 has become a viable option, as it's more conducive for parking than bigger vehicles, while traditionally being seen as more economical. Up front, setting the 2020 model year apart from 2019, is the integration of the black optic package, with the minimal chrome accents being replaced with a sportier and almost S3-like appearance when staring at the front fascia head-on. By choosing the Premium Plus with the more powerful 2-liter 4-cylinder engine and all-wheel drive, the lower portion of the front bumper will also become more aggressive, with larger non-functional vents with a mesh grille design. You'll get full LED headlights with all-weather lighting, along with high beam assist, to make driving at night or in adverse weather much safer. Moving to the side profile, this A3 is sitting on 18-inch 5-arm trapezoid design high-gloss black finish wheels, which came equipped on Audis with the black optic package, except these are scaled down a bit. Body color folding side mirrors with turn signal indicators complete the front portion of the A3. And due to the minor cosmetic differences from last year, this car has become more youthful while taking on the road presence of Audi's product line of S models. Coming around back, you'll get full LED taillights with Audi's signature progressive turn signals being incorporated into the design. You'll get dual exhaust outlets, and just like up front, the design cues differ from the base model, with a more enhanced rear bumper and diffuser. Overall, the athletic look for the A3 in its final year before a facelift gives drivers a fun and classy car at an affordable price range. But what about performance? Under the hood, this A3 is powered by a 2-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder engine that puts out 228 horsepower and 258 pound-feet of torque, and is paired with a 7-speed dual-clutch automatic transmission. You can option for a more economical and less powerful 4-cylinder engine. However, you will be making sacrifices, as you won't receive Audi's quattro all-wheel drive system, and instead, you'll have a front-wheel drive drivetrain. With a 0-60 time of 5.4 seconds, the A3 is actually deceptively quick, and with a smooth ride, the driving experience on your daily commute will most certainly be enjoyable. For fuel economy, you can expect to receive 22 miles per gallon in the city and 30 miles per gallon on the highway. Before stepping inside, you're greeted by a flat bottom steering wheel and power adjustable heated front sports seats with the S logo embroidered into the leather as part of the final edition package. You can option for red leather seats, which has never been available for the third generation of the A3. Once inside, in front of you, is Audi's virtual cockpit, which is arguably the best digital display on the market, as resolution and quality are top-notch. To receive the 12.3-inch display, you will have to opt for the $2,000 navigation package, but I definitely say it's worth the price. Moving over to the infotainment system, this is Audi's older MMI user interface, and unlike the touchscreen we experienced in the S4 and even the Q3 last year, you'll have a rotary dial with quick access buttons to get you to different menus. Apple CarPlay and Android Auto compatibility come standard, and we also have onboard navigation and the Bang & Olufsen 14-speaker sound system. Responsiveness is good, and I'd argue that the rotary dial makes navigating through the infotainment system very seamless compared to a touchscreen. You'll get a rear backup camera with trajectory, along with front and rear parking sensors, and rear cross-traffic alert. Below, you'll find the button for your drive mode selector, which provides different drive modes to choose from, affecting throttle response and steering. You'll also find the dials and buttons for your dual-zone climate control and 3-level heated seats. As we get closer to the center console, a 12-volt outlet and USB input will allow you to connect your smartphone to the car. For the center storage compartment, a hidden wireless phone charging pad and an additional USB input will keep your phone out of sight. But more importantly, from an interior design perspective, this is a great use of the limited space you have in the A3. And rounding out the front seating area, a panoramic sunroof will come standard, which lets in a lot of natural light. Now for passengers in the back, they're going to experience enough legroom depending on how tall they are. And also you got to keep in mind the size of this vehicle, but also what you're buying it for. Now I'm 5'5", so I can fit really in any car. It wouldn't matter to me. But I do have enough legroom to work with. I'd be comfortable even with the seat adjusted all the way back or most of the way back. But one thing to keep in mind here, though, is that if you are buying an Audi A3, passengers in the back isn't really a priority, or having people in the back isn't really a priority at all, because most likely you either don't have a family or you're just focused on yourself and maybe the front passenger. So that's always something to keep in mind. If you are focused on having more rear legroom, then definitely go with maybe an A4, Q3, or Q5. But again, this is more of an entry-level car for the Audi brand, and really, you're probably a younger driver, or maybe just somebody who wants to have a fun daily driver, and you don't really have passengers all the time with you. And then moving on, I will say that the center seat, you can fit someone here, for sure, just depending on how tall the people and how big the people are on either side of you. Now, I will say that because the rear hump is aggressive and the placements for your feet really is kind of challenging, this car is better suited for just two people in the back, and that's normal for all cars of this size and this segment. And then, on the driver's side, the seat is adjusted to someone of my height, and I have a lot of room here. So if you are a shorter person, and maybe you're a short driver and you're a short person as well, you're going to have enough legroom to work with here. You'd be very comfortable back here. But again, when it comes to taller passengers, or just having passengers here all the time, I think you might want to go with a bigger car. But again, most likely, rear passengers or rear legroom isn't a priority or a concern. And rounding out the rear seating area, you do get two rear air vents, so you will not get three-zone climate control, which you never expect to see in a car in this segment or price range. You also get two USB inputs, a center armrest, with two cup holders. Now for rear cargo room, you're going to find just around 10 cubic feet of rear cargo space. Now that's with all-wheel drive. With front-wheel drive, you're looking at 12 cubic feet, so it's slightly more practical. But with what you get, this is definitely enough for groceries, daily shopping, daily commuting. I think if you're really focused on practicality, you'd go with a Q3, and that's what I would recommend. But if you're a young driver who doesn't have a family, or just somebody who doesn't need that extra practicality, this will work just fine. Now, at the end of the day, the Audi A3's primary goal is to draw in new buyers to the brand, whether it's younger drivers or consumers who are just getting into entry-level luxury territory when it comes to pricing. And I think a lot of German brands overlooked this segment, especially in the era of crossovers. So we're seeing BMW come out with a 2 Series Grand Coupe. Mercedes-Benz has an A-Class now that undercuts the CLA in terms of pricing. But I think a lot of brands are understanding that under $40,000 is a sweet spot for a lot of consumers, whether it is younger drivers or maybe just people who are looking to get into a German car over Japanese or American. And what I will say is that once you get behind the wheel of an Audi or a German car in general, there's no going back. You're not going back to American or Japanese. You're going German. You've caught the bug. There's no looking back. However, with the Audi A3, you do get a really nice interior. You get dual zone climate control, flat bottom steering wheel with the final edition package. You also get paddle shifters and Audi's virtual cockpit, which I like the most because it's very high quality. And in my opinion, the best digital display you can find really in any segment, because they provide you with really high quality and resolution along with the navigation system in front of you. So I really like that. What I do want to point out, though, is that for the 2021 refresh, this will all be different. The center console and the infotainment system will all be different. And most likely, there is a possibility that the infotainment system will be integrated into the dashboard, similar to what we found with the Audi Q3. Now, also what would be up in the air is the rotary dial. Now, I think that maybe Audi might keep it, although not 100% sure on that. So if you prefer using a rotary dial like I do, definitely take that into consideration whether you're going to buy a 2020 or 2021 Audi A3. But overall, I think this is just a really great value for the price, especially where I think when it comes to exterior appearance, but also interior quality, this is just a really great option to go with if you are a consumer looking for a car around $40,000. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe for more. And I'll see you guys next time.